my studio in the Scottish Highlands. I'd like to share with you my painting of a curling bonspiel by taking you for a walk around it. I chose to base the composition on an oval, an ellipse which would sweep the viewer's eye around the painting. From the two foreground figures, the gateway to the scene, all the other figures sweep outwards in two arcs and on into the distance. As you can see, those on the left portray the work that went into preparing the sheets of ice, whilst those on the right depict games in action and all the skills of throwing a stone. In the foreground, the base of the ellipse is formed by the snow lying over the ice. From this point, I then draw your eye through the centre of the painting, over a second ellipse, the target etched carefully in the ice, and onward still, towards the distant players. And finally, the brazier, which was keeping the soup warm for the end of the day's play. The figures throughout were chosen for their dynamic silhouettes, but just as important is their negative shapes. Look at the shapes created between figures, and also between their reflections in the ice. These help to keep our eyes engaged and excited, and with their help, the whole painting ripples with movement. But before we move on, one final figure to spot. The all-important piper, standing on the far left, an essential participant in any Highland bonspiel. Now I'd like to show you that the traditional techniques I employ in my old painting involve a succession of layers. With each layer, the overall colour and balance across the entire painting is refined in order to achieve the impression of space and light. There is absolutely no rushing this process. It requires meticulous attention and considerable patience. The paint surface must be discovered and explored. It cannot be forced or overwhelmed. This is what makes painting particularly exciting for me, and especially so in the use of traditional techniques. The result is almost inevitably a discovery, an unexpected delight to be exploited, and it is this element of the unexpected which encourages me to push the limits of my work. Layering is essential. It allows the gradual buildup of colours from dark to light, and then the finishing flourish of pure highlights. In this way, light can be created not only through colour, but from physical texture. This same texture is then available to exploit through the more delicate application of glazes and tints, the transparent and semi-transparent layers which enrich the paint surface. At the time of year in which this island scene took place, the sun was low on the horizon. The scene was bathed in its light as it skimmed over the hills on the right. Positioned here, I was able to use it to provide a gentle foil, a delicate counterbalance to the otherwise almost symmetrical composition. As you can see, its light is carried downwards as a reflection into the ice, and its shadow is spread outwards, diverging across the landscape. This gave me the exciting opportunity to throw all the figures into silhouette against the sun's brightness, so that each could be backlit with a halo of golden light. However, There is nothing uniform about these highlights. Each figure had to be treated separately, according to its position to the sun, so that each highlight would describe its figure accurately. It's all very well enjoying the act of capturing such an occasion and the calculations involved in lighting it, but in the end it needs to be convincing. One has to believe that all the elements feel right and that the event is taking place here and now, before your eyes. That is when a long-acquired knowledge of traditional techniques come into play, along with the determination to overcome each challenge as it occurs along the long path of painting such a complex narrative work.